You're listening to the audio production of Weight Loss Hero, Transform Your Mind and Your Body with a Healthy Keto Lifestyle by Christine Carter, published by Zondervan and read by Chloe Dolandis. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit www.harperchristianaudio.com.
Foreword. I am a lover of food, and I have made it my mission to share great recipes developed in my home kitchen for the home cook. I love food so much that I have made a life out of recipe development and food photography, so I am fortunate to have turned these passions into a career that is fulfilling and keeps me healthy. However, I didn't always love food. I went from being a picky child who loved only a handful of foods to a young adult who saw food as the enemy. When I was a teenager, food made me sick with terrible stomach pains. As I got older, food still made me sick, and it also made me fat. For me, no food was good. It was all bad. Just like Christine, I tried just about every diet in existence, and they all had the same message. Food is the enemy. Less is more. Struggle harder for your goal. Everything changed when I was introduced to the paleo lifestyle. I started to see the good in food, but those pesky health issues and the extra weight didn't disappear as I hoped. Instead, it took a chance reading of Keto Clarity by Jimmy Moore to provide the final piece of the puzzle for me. And then everything came full circle when Jimmy asked me to co-author the companion book, Keto Clarity Cookbook. Now, without a doubt, I can say I love food and see it as an important tool that brings joy in my daily life. I am so honored to write the foreword of this amazing resource. Christine is so relatable. We all have a diet history, and she shows us how to move on from our patterns in a healthy and simple way. She is like a coach, teaching us how to use her book and get the most out of this resource. And I love that Christine recommends that when you hear a new idea or exercise in the book, to stop listening. Stop and think about the new idea and how it fits into your life. Instead of breezing by something new, scary, or different. This is great advice, and if you do it, I know you'll get results from this amazing book. As a professional food blogger and recipe developer, I turn to the recipe section of any book first. The recipes included in the accompanying PDF are crazy simple, yet flavorful. I am thoroughly impressed and can't wait to try the breakfast sausage balls and the volcano roll in a bowl. Christine says right away, simple recipes are my jam. The recipes included in the accompanying PDF are great if you are busy, don't have time for fussy ingredients and cooking methods, or are simply new to cooking. If there is one important message to get, it's that you are not alone. Christine shares her story so bravely, not to just show how far she has come, but so we can all see another person who has struggled with diet and health. She goes from not wanting to be seen at all to sharing herself fully. When we see ourselves and our struggles in another person, we can begin to see what is possible for ourselves. Not only will you discover lots of information and how-tos on changing your lifestyle and eating habits, but you'll also find support and encouragement from someone who has been through the trenches and come out vibrant on the other side. The inspiration and stories along the way make lifestyle change seem real and possible for anyone. Christine instills the most important thing of all through her personal story and journey. Hope. Heather Rushen, author of Keto Clarity Cookbook. Introduction. Getting off the roller coaster. I feel like I already know you because I've been you. Sure, our stories and journeys are unique, but we both have faced challenges and found ourselves stuck in the same unhealthy lifestyle. The feeling of hopelessness on this lonely road of being sick and tired of feeling sick and tired is universal, despite our different circumstances. And I am confident this book will provide you with some insight and answers for how to take the first steps toward a new life. My genuine prayer is that as you listen to this book, you find your aha moment. I ask you to open your heart to the possibility that maybe there is a better life out there waiting for you. You just need to be brave enough to chase after it. My goal is not to be a hero for you, but to help you discover the hero that already lives inside of you. To get the best use of this book, I suggest approaching it like a life guide. When you come to a new idea or exercise, stop listening to the book and really think it through, write it out, and put it into motion. Gaining the knowledge to change your life for the better is good, but it is fairly useless if you don't turn that knowledge into action. Back in 2014, I felt like I had lost everything except the weight. Topping the scales at 297 pounds, I had no direction in life. The harder I tried to lose weight, the harder the process became. I lost my health, my dignity, my confidence, and my happiness. But more important, I lost myself. I didn't love myself anymore, and honestly, I didn't even like myself. I tried every diet known to man. I experimented with fad diets, starving myself, and the good old lifestyle change, eat right and exercise, with the hope that somewhere along the way, I would discover the self-control I needed lurking in the shadows of my mind. I even had weight loss surgery. I just knew that surgery would be the fix I had been searching for and would solve all my problems. Unfortunately, not long after the surgery, I was confronted by the harsh reality that even having a portion of my stomach surgically removed would not save me. I continued to repeat the same patterns, gaining and losing weight over and over again. I eventually ended up exactly where I had started. I found myself still, even after putting myself through a painful and expensive weight loss surgery, strapped to the roller coaster ride I never wanted to be on. Each time I started a new diet plan, I was all in for a week, maybe even two, until my old habits and routines snuck back up on me. Then I would fall off the crazy ride and fall hard. I'd binge eat my way back to where I began, and I always managed to pick up a few extra pounds along the way. I literally dieted my way to 297 pounds. It's not that the diet plans or fitness plans I tried couldn't have worked. It was my ability to stick to them that failed me time and time again. This roller coaster cycle continued to the point that fear prevented me from even wanting to try again. Perhaps you can relate on some level. The fear of failing can be absolutely crippling, and the thought of trying again gave me debilitating anxiety that made even breathing feel like a nearly impossible task. The only thing that brought comfort in my life was food, and the idea of taking it away was terrifying. What if I fail again? What if I can't do it? What if I'm meant to be overweight and live in shame forever? As the number on the scale climbed, so did my depression and anxiety. I was on every prescription drug my doctor could recommend to help me function. I had to take medications for the side effects of other medications. Meds on meds on meds. My entire body hurt, and my mind was a mess. I felt stuck, like there was no way out. My rock-bottom moment came during a time that should have been fun. I was on my way to a family reunion, one I hadn't attended in years. I felt so ashamed about who I had become, and I didn't want to go. My dad begged and pleaded for me to come, so I pulled myself together enough to get dressed and to make the 5-hour drive to South Texas. I remember that morning so vividly. I frantically searched for something to wear that would minimize the excess weight I was carrying. I wanted so badly to blend into the background and hope no one would notice I was there. I found a solid black t-shirt and a maxi skirt to hide the pounds I believed defined me. And then I reluctantly departed to spend time with people whom I should have been happy to see. When I arrived at the family reunion, I spotted my favorite uncle across the room. I had not seen Uncle Bruce in many years, but to me, it felt as if it were yesterday. He began walking my way to say hello, or so I thought. As Uncle Bruce approached me, he looked me in the eyes, gave a casual nod, said hi, and kept on walking. How rude. Why didn't he stop to talk to me? Did I do something wrong? Had I offended him somehow? All sorts of anxious and unreasonable thoughts flooded my mind. I followed him and grabbed him by the shoulder, exclaiming, "Uncle Bruce, it's me, Christine." He was shocked. He had no idea who I was. I was devastated. He didn't recognize me because of the 120 pounds I had gained since the last time he had seen me. I spent the better part of 4 mortifying minutes trying to explain who I was before my uncle was able to make the connection with the person now standing in front of him. I had literally eaten myself to an unrecognizable state. I didn't know much, but when I left, I knew one thing. I would never feel that way again. At my worst moment, I felt completely broken. My self-esteem had been shattered into so many pieces, I thought it was beyond repair. I was desperately in need of a total transformation and had no idea where to begin. When I began my weight loss journey for the last time, hoping to finally get off the emotional roller coaster that had defined my life for far too long, I knew one thing I had to change. If I wanted to fix the outside, I had to fix the inside first. This realization was as exciting as it was terrifying. How does someone fix the inside? Where would I start? Lucky for me, God had a plan and provided the guidance I needed in the same way I want to guide you. During the journey that lay ahead of me, I slowly began to uncover the warrior within me that had been lost for so long. I embraced a beautiful relationship with God, who was waiting with his arms stretched wide. I finally found my breakthrough, and I am here to help you find yours. When I finally got serious, I identified a few things I had to be honest with myself about. I did not like to cook. I did not like to work out. And I liked to eat out. Believe it or not, these were things I didn't have to change. I had a moment of clarity when I realized I didn't have to alter everything about who I am. I just had to change what I did and how I thought. It's less about changing who you are and more about discovering who you were created to be in the first place. This realization allowed me to fully commit to the process. I had to start by examining what was going on inside in order to see the changes on the outside. Initially, I thought I had a weight problem. I believed if I could just lose the weight, all my problems would somehow disappear. However, during this transformative process, I came to realize the weight was not the cause of my problems, but the symptom of something lurking much deeper beneath the surface. If I wanted to see lasting change, something would have to be different this time. The process I followed to discover those things lurking beneath the surface, preventing me from making real changes and achieving a physical transformation, included a 3-pronged approach to weight loss that I will teach you in this book. 1. A total mindset makeover. 2. An effective but simple diet that includes delicious and easy-to-make food. 3. Basic and unintimidating workouts. Throughout this journey, I have consistently heard that I am an overcomer. By definition, an overcomer is someone who has made the best of a conflict. But my story is not that of someone who has overcome. It is a story of a young woman who must decide every day to be brave, bold, and fearless, even when she can think of every reason not to be. I am not an overcomer, because this journey lasts a lifetime. I will never stop overcoming both new and old challenges in my life. I quickly realized this process meant slaying the giants that taunted me, overpowering the addictions that crippled me, and challenging the voice in my head that said I wasn't enough. And I am here to help you do the same. The simple secret to true and lasting change is that it must start in your mind and burn through your body. If we don't address what's going on in our heads and our hearts, we will never find the ongoing success we are looking for. You cannot live the life of your dreams while operating in the same mindset that broke you down. There are a few mindset patterns you will need to rewrite. Retraining your brain can take some time, and you must learn to be patient and gentle with yourself. You will fail. You will mess this all up, probably more than once. But I am here to help you discover the fighter that lives inside of you, who will always come back swinging. Even after taking a punch, you will learn to stand up each and every day and fight for the kind of life you want to live, the life you deserve to live. I fell so much in love with this process of retraining my brain and redefining my own life that I've created a platform to support others on their journey. This passion led me to become a certified personal fitness instructor with a specialized certification in behavioral change, which is a process I plan to share with you. As you listen to this book, keep a pen and paper handy. In the chapters ahead, there will be mindset exercises for you to work through. My request is that you really dive into them, embrace them, and apply them. It is so easy to hear something you know would be helpful to incorporate into your life and think, "Oh, I'll do that later," then move on with your life. While it's true that knowledge is power, it is in the application of that knowledge that freedom exists. You have the power within you to determine your path. So strap on your running shoes and run the beautiful race that is your life. We are on this earth for only a little while, and it's time we make this moment count. Together, we will find the seed already planted deep within you and nurture and love it to become the beautiful flower that is waiting to bloom. I've had the privilege of helping thousands of women around the world achieve their fitness goals, and now I'm here to help you. Please join me in my mission to make the world a happier and healthier place, 1 pound at a time. Part 1. You Are What You Think. Chapter 1. Where It All Began. I'd like to invite you along my personal journey. Through this journey and my experience working with thousands of women worldwide, I have found the weight most of us carry is our best effort to put a Band-Aid over a bullet hole. We have spent the majority of our lives being told we aren't supposed to feel feelings, and we are expected to have it all together, or at least look like we do. The problem is that we were created to have feelings, and our feelings are valid. Most of us have unhealed pain and are seeking something to fill the void of that pain so that maybe we can go one more day without hurting. Food provides us a temporary relief to the feelings we aren't facing until the very thing pacifying us becomes the thing that's killing us, killing our mind, killing our body, and killing our spirit. I didn't want to admit I had problems lurking below my very unhealthy skin surface. I was eating away every undealt with feeling I had because I didn't want to face the truth. Everyone has a story of how they got to their...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.